So you bought yourself a GT86 or BRZ, and you got used to the 200 crank horsepower within an hour of buying the car. So what do you do now? Well, that obviously depends on the budget and exactly what you want from your car. So what we are going to do today is go from the basic mods to more extreme mods and explain all the mods you need to go from 200 horsepower to the crank all the way to 500 to the wheels and everything in between. Okay, so let's start by talking about the stock GT86 or BRZ. The FA20 makes 197 horsepower to the crank, like I mentioned previously, but that equates to around 155 to 160 on the wheels, which really isn't impressive for a sports car. Yes, it's small and light, but just about any hard hatch will drop a BRZ. I mean, 0 to 100 is reached in a sluggish 7.8 seconds. But don't fear, Uncle Chris is here with all the info you need to change your BRZ or 86 from this. Do this. So you have two routes when it comes to building your FA20. You can either keep it naturally aspirated, but you'll have a much lower ceiling, or you can add boost. Now, naturally aspirated is much cheaper and more people will be able to afford it, so let's start there. First upgrade, a cold air intake and upgraded MAF piping. You know I would start here. You can expect around 5 to 10 extra wheel horsepower. Bonus feature, it sounds much cooler. Next, and probably most important for this car, a set of performance headers. Why is this so important? Well, the car is known for its horrible torque dip in the middle of the rev range. The torque dip is caused in part by the design of the exhaust manifold, so it will help alleviate the problem. It's not perfect, but it will help, and on top of having a much smoother and better power band, the car will also add around 10 wheel horsepower. So it's just a win-win. Then you'll need to do an exhaust system and tune next. This bed with the headers will completely fix the torque dip and it will sound way better and add around 20 horsepower. So let's tally up all the power at the end of the day. So stock the FA20 makes around 160 horsepower to the wheels, we added around 40, so just with this 4 mods your FA20 can make around 200 wheel horsepower. And all of this is not too expensive, it's not too difficult, and it should still be reliable. But if you are like me, 200 horsepower ain't enough. We need more power. So let's say you want to make 250 to 300 horsepower to the wheels. You will need to add boost. These motors are surprisingly strong. Adding a turbo supercharger with the stock fueling system and all the mods I previously mentioned, your car can actually make between 250 and 300 horsepower to the wheels. Upgrade the tires and suspension and you'll have a great street car with more than enough grunt for your day-to-day needs. This is where I would recommend most people to stop. Pushing the car past this level is where it starts to get expensive and more risky. But hey, if you have the cash and the balls, why not? So in order to go past 300 horsepower, you'll need to upgrade the fuel system. I'm talking pump, injectors, the whole works. You need to upgrade the clutch and flywheel because the stock flywheel setup won't handle more than that power. Anyways, the stock motor can make around 500 horsepower. Full blown, build a completely stock motor FA20 to 521 horsepower and it's still running strong. Mods include a GTX35 Garrett, 3-inch downpipe, big intercooler, 50mm tail blower valve, 44mm tail wastegate, 1000cc injectors, a 270 low pressure fuel pump and a FX400 clutch. And obviously a great tune with race gas. But at 500 horsepower, it seems like the engine won't be your biggest problem. The stock transmission struggles with this power. This also seems to depend. Some people blow transmissions at 400 wheel horsepower, where other people manage to make it to 500 with no issues. So it probably comes down to the driving style and how aggressive you drive your car. Now, would I recommend a 500 horsepower build on stock internals? No, I wouldn't. Yes, the motor can make 500, but for how long? Rather build a 350 horsepower street car that you know will be reliable and fun. But if you want to go to 500 horsepower, I would recommend building the motor, sleeve it, do the connecting rods and pistons, and add a set of ARP bolts and studs so you have the peace of mind knowing the motor can handle the power happily without any problems. So there's your guide. 200 horsepower naturally aspirated without too many mods. 250 to 300 on stock fueling with boost. We're going to 350 with no issues, but you need to do the clutch. And then if you want to go to 500 horsepower, it shouldn't have any issues, but nobody can promise it, and your transmission might not be able to handle it. So there is your guide. If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe if it helped. Leave a comment. If you disagree with anything, leave a comment. If you want to add anything, again, leave a comment. Like I said, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe. Go through my channel. I've got many more videos just like this one. I'll check you guys in the next one. Cheers, aye.